Hello my crafty friends and welcome to another card making video. Today I'm going to play with wax seals. And although these are meant to be used where you close the envelope for a lovely touch, they are also great to be used as main focal points or elements on your card front. You can find a big variety of colors of waxes that you can use. I have four of the colors here, and these are by Altenew. And you can find them as beads, like the ones that I have here in a jar, which are very convenient to use. You can see here you just add four or five of those in a spoon and you just melt them. And the other way is to get those sticks, like candlesticks. These also come in a variety of colors, but I'm not a big fan of them. You have to hold them and wait for droplets of wax to start falling. Although this process is more authentic, it takes a lot of time and I'm not a big fan of it. You'll also find lots of designs to use for your seals, including images and words. And I got this handy little stand so I can have my tea light underneath, so you don't have to hold the spoon until the wax melts. I like to keep everything inside one of those tins by Tim Holtz. And today I'm going to share three different cards using mainly dies from the latest standalone die release by Altenew, and share different ideas on how I like to use the waxes on my card front. So here I use this lovely die. This is the Moroccan cover-up die, and I did cut it out from white cardstock. It's one of those beautiful backgrounds that you can use again and again on your cards. I'm going to lay it completely flat today on my card, but I can think of so many ways to create shaker cards with this one. I'm also combining flowers from this die set. This is the Craft Flower Buttercup, and I'm going to cut out everything that I need out of the gradient cardstock. I will use these three colors for the flowers and two of the green ones. So just by following the instructions on the front of the packaging, I did cut out everything, and now I'm going to put them together. Before sticking everything down, I did a little bit of thinking just to give some more dimensions and some extra something on my flower. As today I'm mainly focusing on the waxes, I didn't share how I put the flower together, but really it is just die cutting with different colors of cardstock, and then you just follow the instructions of the packaging to put everything together. So I created a big flower, a couple of buds, and I also cut out lots of leaves. For my sentiment, I went with one that is included in the Essential Sentiment Strip die set. This is definitely one of my favorites. I keep on using sentiments from this set again and again. So in this case, I went with the one that says, "You are so kind." I cut it out from black cardstock, and then at the back, I'm just adding a scrap piece of white cardstock so that the words are readable. Now I'm going to light the candle, and I was debating whether I want to use the red or the golden one. I decided to go with the golden one, and I'm taking a look at the seals that I have. I decided to go with the one that has an envelope on top, perfect for any card. I'm going to add in the spoon four or five of these beads. These are enough, and I'm going to leave that spoon there until it melts. Now you can create your composition and pour that wax directly on top, but I know that most of us are too afraid to do that, since we can ruin a work that we have done up to now. So what I like to do is to drop that wax on top of my class mat. You can do that also on a non-stick craft mat or even on a silicone mat. Also, now is a great time to wipe your spoon clean. And now my seal is ready. So let's see what we have here. Always remember that if you don't like the seal or if you made a mess with it, just put it back in the spoon. It's going to melt again and you don't have to waste any product. And now you can easily use glue at the back and stick it on your project. So for my project now, I'm cutting a 4.25 by 5.5 vanilla cardstock. This has a lovely shine on it, and I'm going to stick my design on top of it. I'm not adding any dimension, I'm just going with glue at the back, and I'm going to stick it completely flat. If you want to have some shadows or dimension, the easiest way is to cut it out 3 or 4 times so you can stack one on top of the other to create dimension. This design is so intricate that it is almost impossible to fight with tiny little foam tape for the back. Then I placed down the sentiment and arranged everything all around the sentiment. For the seal, I went with a piece of foam tape at the back. I like how the color of the seal matches with the center of my flower, so everything comes together nicely, and I love how I have a seal on the front of my card, which isn't something common. I think it makes the card extra special. So here is an idea of how we can incorporate a seal as an element of a cluster card, and you can see some close-up photos of this card here. For my second card, I'm going to use another cover die from the latest release. This is the Picking Leaves cover die. It's absolutely stunning, perfect for creating clean and simple cards. For this card, I'm going for a very easy design that you can easily mass produce. And all I'm going to do is to combine the cover die, which I'm going to cut it out from gold cardstock, and the dark background, and I find it is very elegant when you combine gold on top of dark green or silver on top of navy blue. Now this is a very intricate design. If you are using thick cardstock, make sure to use your metal seam. And if something doesn't pop up, don't worry about it. You can consider it as a design element. So all I'm doing here is inking up the edges of my background to make them even darker. This is going to make as if the center is highlighted. And then to add an extra touch, I'm going to use one of my gold metal watercolors. These are from Altenew. I'm going to pick the one of the goldens that are available that matches the gold of my cover panel. And I'm not going to add too many, just a few will do the trick. This is going to add some shine and interest on my background. And it is an otherwise very simple card, however it has lots of sparkle and it's really striking. To stick down the panel, I'm using my Burley Art Glue. It is super fine in the tip and it is really helpful. Plus, when some glue oozes out, which is going to happen here, you probably will see that. It's not a big problem. This is not going to be shiny when it dries. And of course, it's going to dry matte and completely clear. This time again, I went with my golden beads. And on top, I'm going to add a seal that has a lovely flower on it. Leave it on top for a few seconds until the wax becomes solid again. Then you can peel it off and stick it on your project. Of course, if you are brave enough, you can directly pour that wax on your project, which is something that I'm going to do for the next card. Clean and simple, very easy to mass produce, and I think it is really striking. And of course, all I have to do now is to stick this panel on top of a standard card that's 4.25 by 5.5. Actually, I love how the design on the flower matches the design of the leaves with all those lines. That was accidental, but it's those little things that make me happy. And let's move on to the third card for today. This time I'm using leaves from this lovely die set. This is called Tropical Leaf Mixed Die Set. I absolutely love the completely unique designs of these leaves. I'm going to choose three of them and cut them out from blue cardstock, white cardstock and silver glitter cardstock. This time I'm going with blue beads for my wax and I'm going to create a composition, and I will be brave in this card. I'm going to pour the wax directly on top of my elements. So I'm just going to temporarily adhere one on top of the other to create the composition so I know exactly where I am supposed to pour the wax. I'm adding glue only at the bottom of my leaves, and I make sure that I have quite of a dimension and movement at the top of them. My background panel is a light gray cardstock. Since I have a white leaf, I didn't want to have a white background, just to help it pop a little bit more. This time I will use a seal that is going to act as a sentiment at the same time. And I have a dot here with a marker, so I know where is the top of my word. And of course, of all the times that my camera could stop filming, it was the exact time that I wanted to place the seal on top of my wax. But in any case, everything went just smoothly. I didn't make a mess. Everything went just fine. I'm waiting for the wax to cool down. And then we can see what I've done. You will notice that the word hello is slightly crooked, but I think this is the beauty of creating a seal directly on top of your project. The fun part is that the seal in this case works as an adhesive at the same time, keeping all the elements in place. I'm just going to stick this on top of a standard card that's 4.25 by 5.5 using some foam tape at the back, and I'm going to finish it off by adding some silver gems. In this design I could have embossed the grey panel for my card just to add something extra on the background, however I like the simplicity of this card, but here is an option for you in case you want to case it. And these were the cards for today. I hope that you had fun, that you got inspired. Don't forget to leave me a comment, to like the video and also subscribe if you haven't done so already. Also, this is part of a blog hub where we celebrate the latest release by Altenew, so make sure to visit my blog, you will find there all the info that you need on how you can enter the giveaways. Also, down below in the description area, you will find links to everything I used. Thank you all so much for spending some time with me today, and I hope you'll all have a lovely day.